Hello friends, welcome to medicine classes for dummies. Today we will be discussing about the vest zones of lungs. So these vest zones were described by John B. West. He has divided the lungs into four zones: zone 1, 2, 3 and 4. So I have described a diagram here in which the red circle indicates the alveoli, and this blue is indicating the intra-alveolar vessels. And I am introducing few terminologies which will be discussed in detail. So this vest zones of lung were described by John B. West. So based on his classification, there are four zones in the lung: zone 1, 2, 3 and 4. Before that, I will make you aware of some of the terminologies which we use to describe these four zones. So P capital A, which denotes alveolar pressure, pulmonary, and this is the alveolar pressure, that is the pressure inside the alveoli. PPA indicates pulmonary arterial pressure, PPV indicates pulmonary venous pressure, and PISF indicates pulmonary interstitial pressure. So what happens is that the blood is pumped from the right ventricle into the pulmonary artery. So this kinetic energy will be reflected in the velocity of the blood in the pulmonary arteries. So this as this blood ascends up the pulmonary artery, at a particular level at the level of heart, this pulmonary artery pressure becomes zero, and as the blood ascends above this level, the pulmonary artery pressure becomes negative. And this pulmonary alveolar pressure, P capital A, that is almost fixed in all the areas of the lung. So above the level of the heart, pulmonary arterial pressure will become negative. And as it comes, that is, for every 1 centimeter rise, there will be a proportionate decrease in the pulmonary arterial pressure, that is from a particular level above the heart. As it comes below the level of the heart, there is an increase in the pulmonary arterial pressure. So first we will see the zone 1. So in zone 1, it is that the alveolar pressure will be more than the arterial pressure. So how it is happening? Because this zone is above the level of the heart, so the arterial pressure will be negative. So since the alveolar pressure is fixed, PA will be more than PPA. So these vessels which are entering into the alveoli for this ventilation, perfusion, that is for the exchange of gases, once it enters into the alveoli, these vessels get compressed. So there will be practically no flow through these intraalveolar vessels because of the positive pressure outside the vessels, which is the alveolar pressure. So this zone is like, there is ventilation is there, but there is no perfusion happening. So there is no blood flow, but ventilation, that is, air is entering from outside, but there is no exchange of gases occurring. So this zone 1 of the lung is like a wasted ventilation or a dead space ventilation, because there is only ventilation, there is no exchange of gases. So practically there is no use for our body by that region. So that is the zone 1. In a normal lung, zone 1 do not exist. But if the patient is in oligemic shock, like there is hypovolemic shock, so that will reduce all the vascular pressures, and so subsequently the pulmonary arterial pressure will also come down. So if the patient is in oligemic shock, this zone 1 will develop in that lungs. Also, other situation in which zone 1 develops, like if the patient is on ventilator and we are giving a large tidal volume ventilation, then this large tidal volume will reflect as a large pulmonary alveolar pressure. So this pressure will increase more than the arterial pressure, and so there will be a zone 1 created. Or if the patient is on ventilator and then we are giving a positive PEEP, positive end expiratory pressure. So if you are giving a positive end expiratory pressure, that will also reflect in the alveolar pressure, and so in that case also alveolar pressure will be more than the arterial pressure, and so zone 1 will be created. So normally in a normal lung there is no zone 1. So zone 1 is created in two scenarios. One is in oligemic shock, and when a patient is on positive pressure ventilation with a large tidal volume or a high PEEP. So in both the cases, this is like a wasted ventilation or dead space ventilation. So in this the extreme this part we are representing the blood flow which is occurring. So here we can see that there is no blood flow occurring in this zone 1. So as we come down, it is the zone 2. In zone 2, the arterial pressure is more than alveolar pressure, but the alveolar pressure is more than the venous pressure. So here the blood flow is determined by the pressure difference between the arterial and the alveolar pressure. And normally in a vascular bed, the blood flow, whether there is a flow occurring in that bed, is determined by the pressure difference between the alveolar and the venous bed. But in this place, in zone 2, this flow is determined by the difference between the arterial and the alveoli, and there is no role for the venous blood pressure. So this zone 2 is now, the blood flow occurring in zone 2 is described as the waterfall phenomenon, Sluice effect. It is also known as the Starling resistor, or it is also known as the wear, W-E-I-R. It is like which is the dam built by the beavers. So what is happening here is pulmonary arterial pressure, we can compare it into a flowing river, and the alveolar pressure, it can be compared to a height of the dam. So it is like river is flowing and it has to flow above the dam. So this zone 2 actually fluctuates. That is, it we cannot say that always it is alveolar pressure, arterial pressure is more than the alveolar pressure. It depends upon the respiratory cycle, it depends upon the cardiac cycle. So what happens is, at some point in the upper parts of the zone 2 will become zone 1 in some parts of the respiratory cycle, and in some parts of the respiratory cycle the lower part of the zone 2 becomes zone 3. So here actually from above downwards the blood flow gradually increases. So this is what it is depicted here. See, as we come down from upper to lower part of zone 2, the blood flow is increasing, and that is known as because as we come down the zone 2, pulmonary arterial pressure gradually increases than the alveolar pressure, and whenever the arterial pressure rises above the alveolar pressure, only the blood flow is happening, and this difference is can be compared to a waterfall or a Sluice effect or a Starling resistor. So here we can see that at some part of the in the upper part of the zone 2, it will be the vessels will sometime behave like this. In the lower part of the zone 2, sometimes the vessel become distended and become more perfused. While in zone 2, in some parts where there is the pulmonary arterial pressure become equal to alveolar pressure, it will be like compressed, or it will be of equal dimension. That will be the two forces will be equally balanced. So that is zone 2. So this is the waterfall phenomenon occurring in the zone 2 of the west zones of lung. So as we come down, again the pulmonary arterial pressure is increasing, and the pulmonary venous pressure also increases. And so in zone 3, this pulmonary arterial pressure will be the highest, and it will be more than pulmonary venous pressure, and the pulmonary alveolar pressure will be lowest. So in zone 3, what happens is the vessels will get distended, because there is no external positive pressure which is compressing the vessels. So the vessels get progressively distended, the vascular resistance decreases, and the perfusion increases. So this difference will be almost constant throughout the zone 2, and so there will be a uniform blood flow in zone 3. It is not like it is gradually increasing down the zone 3, because this PPA, PPV difference is almost fixed in zone 3. So we can see a blood flow like this, which is almost fixed down the zone 3 in the west zone of lung, zone 3. So what happens in zone 4. So as we come down the zones of the lung, the pulmonary arterial pressure will gradually increase and the vessels get distended. So as the vessel get distended more and more, so the pressure inside the vessel will cause the fluids in the vessels to exudate to the outside space because of the over distension of the vessels. So that will result in fluid escaping from inside the from the vessels to the outside space, and that will create an interstitial fluid pressure around the blood vessels. So zone 4, there a new pressure appears, that is the interstitial fluid pressure, that is arising because of the increasing distension of the vessels, which occurs because of the increase in the pulmonary arterial pressure. So the flow in zone 4 will be determined by, so what happens is as we come down, this exudation will increase, and there will be a point in which the interstitial pressure will overtake the pulmonary arterial pressure. And at that time, there will be again the blood flow will reduce. So there will not be a pressure difference, and there will not be again the blood vessels get compressed. So in zone 4, it is the pulmonary arterial pressure and the interstitial pressure fluid difference which determines the blood flow in zone 4. So from zone 3 and zone 4, we have to add one more thing. There is a transpleural pressure which is also coming into play. And that equally affects the alveolar and the arterial and the venous pressure. And so that pressure does not have a significant effect on the arterial venous pressure difference. So these are the four zones of the lung. And this is how the blood flow is distributed in zone 1, 2, 3 and the 4.